Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you how to get an arrow, circle, or other graphic to follow a subject using iMovie. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to more than 700 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign. Join us and get exclusive content and course discounts. So let's say you have some video footage and you want to be able to point out a specific person or an object in the footage even though it's moving. You can create an arrow, circle, or other graphic pretty easily, bring it into iMovie, and animate it so it follows that person along. So I'm going to start off here in Keynote, not in iMovie, because I need to create a graphic like an arrow or circle to follow someone. Now you can use any graphics app that can create transparent images. So you can do this in something like Acorn, Pixelmator, Photoshop, or whatever you want. I'm just going to use Keynote because I know it's free and most Mac users have it. So I've started here with a blank template. I'm going to get rid of the stuff here and I'm going to change the document size over here at Document, Document, and go from widescreen to custom slide size. Now I just need something small just for a little arrow or something. So I'm going to do 480 by 480, a little square. So I have a square shape now. I'm going to add a shape to it. I can do say a circle like this and then go to Format, change the border to a line, and let's make that line red. And then I can take the fill and change it to no fill. So now I have a circle, but for this example I'm going to use an arrow. So I'm going to select the arrow shape here. I'm going to go to Arrange and turn it 270 degrees so it's pointing down, and stretch this thing out a bit so it fills most of this graphic. We'll be able to set the size in iMovie. So I'm not really worried about the size here. I just want it to be as big as possible. So something like that. Let's go and change the style so the fill color is a nice bright red. And to make it stand out on almost any background, I'm going to set a border to white. So it's basically a white border around red, so it'll show up even if the colors are red there. You'll see the white will make it show better. So let's go and export this as a transparent graphic. Couple steps for that. One is click on the background again, or click on the slide here on the left, and then go to Format, Slide Layout, then change the background to no fill. Very important, you have to do this or this won't be a transparent image. You'll get a black box with a red arrow in it instead of just the red arrow. Now go to File, Export To, and Images. And in here select Format PNG and make sure Export with Transparent Backgrounds is checked. Also very important. And then export this out. So I'll just save it. I'll just call it Arrow. And now we can switch into iMovie. So here in iMovie I have some footage of some soccer players and I want to follow one particular soccer player by having this arrow above her head. So let's bring the arrow in. Here in the Finder you can see I called this arrow. So I created a folder called Arrow, and inside it are all of the slides. There's only one slide, just this arrow here. So I'm going to drag that into the timeline here above the clip so it appears here at the top. Now we want to reposition this so it's all the way to the left and it stretches all the way across the entire clip. Right now it's a cutaway, so you can see how it completely replaces the video that's there. I'm going to select it and I'm going to make sure I click here, the video overlay settings. So make sure that's selected and you see this drop down menu, and change from cutaway to picture in picture. Now you'll see it as a small picture in picture and it's transparent. Notice the black background isn't there because I exported it properly from Keynote. And I just have this nice arrow here. I can enlarge it or shrink it. I'm going to make it pretty small like that. And I can place it anywhere I want. But if I play this video, you could see that the arrow just stays in one place. It doesn't move with the player. Now we have to add that functionality. And we're going to do that by using keyframe animation. So let's modify this picture in picture layer here. With it selected, I want to click here to make sure that I'm viewing the picture in picture information. I want to change the fade in and fade out to nothing, so it's there from the very beginning and stays to the very end. And I want to select it down here so you can see there's a yellow outline around it. And I'll select it here near the left. It's really hard to select the left edge, so I'm going to select it near the left and I'm going to use the left arrow on my keyboard to move all the way to the beginning. And now that it's at the beginning, I want to position picture in picture to be at a good starting point. So I'm going to have it over this player right here. So that's a great starting point. And notice these controls here. These are the keyframe animation controls. If you don't see these, sometimes they disappear. Just click here to turn off these controls and click here to turn them back on and they'll appear again. Now we can click here to add a keyframe. Now I'm going to use the right arrow key on my keyboard to advance 5 frames in the video. And you can see the player has moved. I'm going to click here again to add another keyframe and reposition the arrow. Then I'm going to go forward 5 frames again, add another keyframe, and position this just perfectly above her head. You continue to do that about every 5 frames as she moves through the video. Always adding the keyframe first and then adjusting the arrow. Now why every 5 frames? You could do it every single frame if you wanted to. It would just take a really long time. And doing it more than 5 frames really might have the arrow trailing or leading a little bit sometimes. 5 seemed about right, but you may want to choose something else depending upon how fast the action is happening in the video you're using. So let's see where we're at so far. If I use these arrows here, I can go back to the previous keyframe and you can see it jump back the video and the arrow to the previous keyframe. And I could go and look at all the different keyframes here. And I can go forward to go forward until this button isn't active anymore. It means that's the last keyframe. So now I can continue to add another one. And she's disappeared somewhere back there, but we'll keep the arrow moving along. Now with just this so far, I can preview what I've got. So I'm going to slide this back to the beginning here. And I'm going to play the video. And you can see the arrow follows her until the end of my keyframes. Then it just stays there. So now what I've got to do is I have to use these controls. Remember, if they disappear, just click here and here to bring it up again. And make sure you have this selected. I can use this left arrow here to go back to the previous keyframe. And continue. So I'll go 5 more frames. Add a keyframe. Move the arrow. And I'll do that for the entire rest here. So now that I'm all done, I could play it back and see the result. And another thing you can add is a shadow with just clicking this button here. When you add that, it actually adds a little bit of a dark shadow around the object to make it stand out even more from the video behind it. And when you're done, you can always adjust things. So you can click in here, go anywhere that you want, click here to bring up the keyframe tools, use the left and right arrows to go back and forth between all of the keyframes that you've set, and adjust any one of them. So if one's a little bit off, you could adjust it. You could also add extra ones. So you can see this jumps between these 5 frames here, but there's nothing to prevent me from going to a keyframe and then maybe advancing 2 or 3, adding another keyframe in between those existing 2 to fine tune a section where maybe the action's happening a little bit faster. So that's basically how you do it. You can have any single arrow or circle or something follow subjects around in your videos so you can point them out in situations like this.
I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.